The first operation we're talking about is the union of what? Sex. After that, we also talk about the intersection of what? Sex. We know the symbol for union, that's the U shape, and for intersection, the N shape. What does these two operations tell us when we come towards dealing with sets? Okay, let's assume that we have a set A and a set B. We want to operate from them using the union and the intersection and find their what real meaning or deeper understanding. Now, when we talk of A union B, all that we used to do is to collect the individual members in A and in B and arrange them such a way that none of them would appear twice. But what actually comes in play when we are doing those kind of operations? Now, let's take note of this. A union B tells us of three conditions. Someone may ask, what are those conditions? See that very soon. And also, when we have A intersection B, we know we pick members in A which are also found in what B, or members in B which are also found in what A. So here we talk of only one straight condition. So for intersection of set, we have what one condition, which is a very straight one. Now, with these three conditions, we are going to find out the real meaning of what A union B and A intersection B, and it applies to what? All sets. Now, let me introduce you to some symbols I'll be using, because we are being mathematics, we always going to use English spellings all the time. So, anytime you see this symbol, like an apex sign, its meaning is end. And when you see a V-shaped sign, its meaning is all. And when you see a V with a cross stroke, we call it all there is. All there is. And when we have this symbol, which looks like an inverted or laterally inverted E, we call this there exists. So we're using these symbols in place of what? Such words. So we have to take note of that to make our understanding easier. So now let's move back to what we're supposed to do, that is explaining what the intersection and the union of sets means. Taking the first one, when we have a set in patient A intersection, so let's start with the union, A union B. What actually are we talking about? Now let's assume there is an element or a number which falls within this union of sets. We are trying to say that if, assuming X is that what number, we are trying to say X belonging to A union B means that element which we are naming X may be found in set A only, or may be found in set B only, or may be found in both sets A and what B at the same time. Meaning any element that form part of A or B may be found only in A or only in B, or it can also appear in both sets A and B. So these are the three conditions that we're talking about. The first condition, the second condition, and the third condition. But when we come to the intersection of sets, that's A intersection B. What are we talking about? We said we have one straight condition. That means if, assuming X belongs to this intersection, A intersection B, it simply means that the element which is X appears in set A and at the same time appears in what? Set B. If it doesn't appear in both sets at the same time, we don't consider it as what? Part of A intersection B. I'm taking my time to explain this because we're using it in proving some identities and some laws. So we need to take time and go through it. An element belonging to A union B means that element can be found in only set A or only set B, or can be found in both what set A and B. That's the three conditions. And when we talk of intersection of two sets, let's say A and B, if X is a member of this intersection, it means S can be found in A, and at the same time, S can be found in what? B. Without that, this straight condition will not work.